Today I'm going to show every part of the regular sized Galaxy S7 screen and charging port replacement. The phone does get sacrificed during the process, so it should make for an interesting video. First, turn the phone off. Then the easiest part of this whole repair will be removing the SIM card and SD card tray from the top. Now to remove the back panel, we will use a heat gun to help soften the adhesive underneath the back glass. After heating the phone up for a couple seconds, it'll be too hot to touch, and we can stick a giant suction cup on it to gently lift up and away from the phone as we slide our metal pry tool in between the glass layer and the phone layer. This is the hardest part of the whole removal process, so once you have it started, you're probably good to go. That little gap will let us slide a playing card or business card in between the glass and the frame, and then we can slide that around the glass edges, because the business card will go with the curve of the back glass. I'm also putting playing cards underneath the glass so it won't re-adhere back down to the phone again as I'm removing the adhesive. Once you've sliced through the adhesive on both sides, make sure you don't go too deep or you will cut into the QI charger. Then you can remove the back panel. If you need to replace the camera lenses, you can just push those through the back frame. And then there are 12 screws around the back side of the phone. Now this little gold ticket gets you one free chocolate candy bar from Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory, so set that off to the side and save it for later. Then the plastic loudspeaker can be removed from the bottom of the phone. Same thing with the QI charger and then the plastic bit at the top. The nice thing about having a QI charger that doesn't go through the charging port is that if your charging port breaks, your QI charger will still be able to charge your phone through the contacts on the motherboard. I'm disconnecting all these little ribbon cables, starting with the volume rocker, the earpiece, the front sensors, the screen, and the battery. You should probably start with the battery, and then the power button is off to the side over there. Down here at the bottom of the phone, there is the fingerprint scanner, then a couple wire cables. You don't need to disconnect the back one. I just got a little disconnect happy and popped it off anyway. Then you can lift the motherboard away from the phone, just like in the Galaxy S7 Edge. There is one little cable at the bottom of the motherboard. Just unsnap that like a little Lego, and then the motherboard is removed from the phone. Here is the front-facing camera. It's a 5-megapixel. Just unsnap that like a Lego, and then the rear-facing camera on the motherboard here snaps off the same way. It is clicked into the motherboard with this little plastic frame, so you have to unsnap that, and the camera can be removed. Now this phone has been on for a total of 30 seconds. This tape sits right on top of the processors, and with that much discoloration, I wonder if these phones are going to have overheating issues later on. I guess we'll find out. Here's another look at the cameras. The top one is the 5-megapixel front, the bottom one is the 12-megapixel rear. Gonna go ahead and snap those back into the motherboard. Just like little Legos, you'll feel them click into place. With the rear camera, you'll also feel the camera unit itself click in because that plastic frame holds pretty tight. Now the battery removal will need a metal pry tool. I'm gonna use the blunt end of this metal spudger and just slip it in and then pry up little by little all around the edge of the battery. Make sure you do not puncture the battery at all. There's the battery itself. I will link replacement parts down in the video description. There are 3 screws down here by the charging port that allows you to remove the headphone jack. Set that off to the side. Now this is where the problem starts. This is the exact same as the Galaxy S7 Edge, where the back button and the menu button wrap around underneath the screen of the phone. So it makes the charging port repair impossible unless you remove the screen of the phone. Now I assumed that removing the screen of this phone would be easier than with the Galaxy S7 Edge. And I was wrong because the screens are constructed differently. And I'll show you why. So I'm heating up the phone. I slipped a playing card in underneath where the battery was at, all the way to the edge of the screen. And that allowed just enough separation between the screen and the metal frame that I could slip my metal pry tool in. Same thing with the back of the phone. I slipped the playing cards in so it doesn't re-adhere back down on top of itself. And I'm just working my way around the edges. The screen is not going to survive this process. Tried the same trick with the other side, slipping a business card in and hoping that that would lift off the other side of the adhesive. Now down here at the bottom, you do have to watch out for the charging port buttons, the back button and the menu button. And here's where I broke my screen, right here on this corner. I nicked that corner and that made a crack all the way through the LCD. It is super, super fragile. That's why I say that nothing is salvageable when you are removing the screen from your device. So a charging port repair is most likely going to require a screen repair as well. Here's the other difference. The glass and polarizer are not glued to the AMOLED screen. Normally, like with the Note 5 and other Samsung phones, everything is glued together so it's more structurally sound. This screen is not. It is much thinner and does not have the glue there. So now that I've severely destroyed my screen, I'm just going to pull that away from the phone. I will link replacement screens down in the video description. I will need to replace this one, believe it or not. Here's the 3 layers. We got the glass and polarizer that have separated from the AMOLED screen. But now that the screen is off, that will allow us access to the home button and fingerprint scanner, as well as the charging port. Just want to point out, look how thick this aluminum chassis is. No wonder it survived my bin test. Now that we have access to the home button, we can just pop that out from the back side and then slip it through the little hole in the frame. Set that off to the side with all the other components. And then right here, this is where the buttons are wrapped around the midframe and attached to the other side. So I'm going to lift those off gently and then stick them through the midframe, and then I can lift the charging port off of the midframe. This is the charging port. Usually they're pretty cheap, right around 10, 15, maybe 20 bucks. If only it was easier to get at, it would make this phone a lot more repairable. Here are all the components. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments. I will make a part 2 to this video where I reassemble everything once I've purchased the new replacement screen. Thanks a ton for watching. Hit that subscribe button and follow me on Twitter and Instagram for behind the scenes. Hope to see you around.